Sports Card Nation, the hobby is the people. Weekly news and interviews, it's your number one source. Sports Card Nation, the hobby is the people. Sports Card Nation.
What is up? Episode 228. Hope this audio broadcast finds you doing well. Happy to be back. Going to keep the intro short and sweet. My very, very good buddy, Danny Black, who I do card matches with every other week on Mondays and live Friday and then released on audio Monday. A few months back, 3-4 months back, said, hey, I'm thinking about doing this Hobby News Daily website. What do you think, John? And, I asked him to explain kind of more what it was going to entail or his vision for it. And, after he shared that with me, I said, do it. Not only do it, but let me help you a little bit, right, where I can and be a small part of it. So my official title, if you will, is vice president, and Danny's the CEO and founder of it. And it's a great site, hobbynewsdaily.com. And we're going to talk about it. That's going to be the main crux of the conversation. I think something like 15, 16 writers now, content creators with their site on board, and articles every day, a new article, and just something different. Gem Rate giving exclusive data to Hobby News Daily only, and a Hobby News Daily morning minute every morning, a 3 to 6 minute podcast, just kind of to wrap up the day rather quickly. Very consumable, and there's more coming. I know there's more coming. I can't give away all the details, but they're just getting started, and I'm happy to be a part of it as well. So I said, Danny, you got to come on. Let's talk about this site, where it's going, how it became what it is, and how it's going to get bigger and better. And so that's what today's show is going to be. So enough talking. Let's get it started and get Danny on here, and we'll explain all about that.
Hey, John, you want to have a catch?
Time for our Hobby is the People announcer of the week.
Sup, everyone? It's Brody the Kid. Always remember, the hobby is the people. Peace out.
If you'd like to be the Hobby is the People announcer of the week, do a WAV or MP3 file and send it to sportscardnationpc@gmail.com.
Introducing the only auction house dedicated exclusively to the cards of the 1990s. Josh Adams and John Linden have created an auction company solely for the rare, scarce, and hard-to-find inserts and parallels of the 1990s. Whether it be basketball, baseball, football, or hockey, 90s auctions will have it. The auctions will consist of smaller lots between 100 and 120 in total, so your cards won't get lost in the shuffle. Founded on the principles of fairness, honesty, and integrity, 90s Auctions was created by collectors for collectors. Register and co-sign today at 90sauctions.com. That's 90sauctions.com.
Are you a new sports cards collector or someone returning to the hobby? Maybe you're just looking for a friendly, trustworthy hobby community to hang out with and enjoy collecting. Midwest Box Prints has been bringing collectors together for many years with affordable breaks, helpful threads, and a Discord group packed with generous people who genuinely care about the hobby and other collectors. Check out the breaks at MidwestBoxBreaks.com. Our goal is to bring you as much value as possible. Also, find us on Twitter at Midwest Box Prints.
Hey folks, John here. Just wanted to remind you, use the discount code MBB10 for 10% off your first order at MidwestBoxBreaks.com. All right, I want to welcome my next guest to the Sports Card Shop guest line. It's a gentleman I rarely see or talk to, so I'm really excited to get to reconnect. It's been a bit, but my good friend Danny Black, who's the creator and founder of Hobby News Daily, and that's really what we're going to focus on our conversation on today. Welcome, Danny.
Glad to be here. Your check is in the mail as always.
All right, good. I get the mail every day, so I'll text you every day. It doesn't show up. So Hobby News Daily, I'm proud to be, you know, part of it, writer, content creator, a little bit of a consultant, I'd even go as far as to say. It's been a few weeks in. Give you kind of assessment of where it's at in your mind.
Well, right now, I think we're well ahead of where we thought we'd be. This is an idea, and you and I will get into the background a little bit, but something we've kicked around, you know, and talked about for a long time. You definitely helped kind of push me towards ripping the Band-Aid off and going for it. And what we saw immediately was how excited people got. So our initial response has been, I think, far and away beyond what I would have hoped for a launch. I think we didn't know quite what to expect. And then it went somehow even better. That being said, it's a new company. There have been mistakes. Anybody who got our very first email, we're going to look at that and laugh as we sent it out three times, with the problem in the software. But that's part of the fun of launching a new company. What I'm really proud of is like the great articles that have come out in the last couple of weeks. I've had so many people just tell me that it's writing from people that they've never thought they'd get to read, yourself included, just picking a topic that's not part of your regular routine and getting to do a little bit of a special or a feature on it. Has been really cool, and the writers have enjoyed it, and we've gotten a lot of great feedback.
Yeah, no doubt. And even for me, Dan, as you know, I write that Sports Collectors Digest monthly column called The Hobbies the People. So I don't know where that came from, but that's usually like centered on a person, right? You were we featured Card Menches and yourself on that. We've a lot of other people, which is great. So, it's important. But with writing for Hobby News Daily, I can write more topic related content rather than just about a person. So it's a different, for me, it's different and refreshing too at the same time. And I enjoy both aspects. Don't get me wrong, but the nice thing is I can do two different things with two different sort of contents, and that's nice. And like you said, you've got some serious folks on that writing staff, and I think it's funny when you look at, and I won't people go to the website hobbynewsdaily.com, you can see all the writers we're talking about, but I'm a competitive person, so like I think when you have such a writing staff, it pushes me, and I'm sure it works the same way with other people. Like, hey, you better write something halfway decent here, because that room is full of talented folks writing articles too. So how bad do you want to look, John? So I've crumpled up a couple pieces of paper, which is probably, I don't know if that's good or bad, but I think that's a testament to the quality of the people you have on board that are writing. You feel that way?
I was about to say, I think it's a testament not just to the writers, but to the passion of the writers. I have heard that the writers are reading everybody else's articles as much as they're enjoying reading, writing their own articles, because they're getting exposed to, the other writers, on the staff, but you may have never seen them write about these topics. So I'm finding that, yes, I mean, every writer, this is a passion project. Let's not kid ourselves.
And not necessarily in my case, but I think in some people's case too, it's easier to write than to do, a podcast or a verbal representation of what you want to say. So I imagine for some folks, right, they can get out kind of their feelings and their stances and their how they feel about certain topics or things they want to see. And that's always cool. I mean, for me, I do have this show, but sometimes even putting it into written form, maybe you can say it in sort of a different way. And so it's nice to have the ability to have a verbal say and even in a written form as well. And I think others may be one way, the other form. So I think writing can be a good, it is a good, but for some,
maybe a way where they can express their stance where they couldn't before.
One of the cool things was, and this has gone back a couple of weeks, and I don't want to forget anybody, but you wrote about tickets. Well, you know, that's not something you talk about on every episode of Sports Card Nation. Eric Norton wrote about comic books. Horacio Ruiz wrote about collecting G.I. Joe. And these are all people that are unbelievably versed in the hobby, could talk about cards all day long, but have more to their collectible portfolio, have more interest in that. So then we have plenty of people writing about cards, and they're fantastic artists. Let me tell you, Jason's Vintage Vignettes article that he came out with was fantastic. If anybody missed that, Drew Herndon did a great breakdown on Optic Football. So there's a lot of great card articles, but just getting to see people like yourself get to do something that, I'm going to choose my words tactfully here, there's no recourse. And I don't want to say there's no recourse, but there's no recourse. You get to write a fun article. You know, I'm, and I want you to have that opportunity. And that's true for all the writers. And that's part of my sales pitch when we ask people to come on board is, what have you always wanted to write about that you haven't had the chance? You know, what's your pet project? And the passion and the quality of the stuff that's come out has been really, really fun as a collector and as a hobbyist.
Yeah, no doubt. And, you know, you can write. Right, like you, I think you said it perfectly, Danny. Like maybe I can't do necessarily a whole ticket on a whole episode on something, but I can write an article. Now, full disclosure, I did do an episode of Hobby Quick Hits on tickets,
but that's again, your short show. That's your quick hits.
Yeah, yeah. But writing and verbal art, even though they're similar and they're both obviously forms of communication, they're different methods of delivery, and you can do different things with each one of them. Let's take it back really to the birth of the site and the group. Right. How did it happen? When did you think about it? Kind of for those, obviously I know from being very good friends with you, but for those that, hey, how did it start, Danny? You know, take those folks on how it all began.
Well, I think you saw kind of, it was a process. I don't know that there was one aha moment, but I think there was a, hey, you know, wouldn't it be cool if we could get something like this? Well, then, yeah, but you know, it'd be even cooler if we added this. Well, if we have that, we should really add this. Well, you know, that sounds like a really cool idea. You know, John, you think I should do something like that? And your answers were honest. It's a big undertaking. You think it's a great idea. You know, if I can go for it, go for it. You're extremely supportive. I mean, you know, off the record, I'll save all the criticism and stuff you told me to fix. But no, I mean, you were my Tom Higgins in this. And as we got it off the ground, and it was, you shared and you understood that what I was doing was to help the hobby. And so that was the moment. When we said there's something here to help the hobby and we can get that out there, and there's other writers and there's other people who do content creation and they all are happy to help the hobby. I mean, it's a win-win for everybody. So once we started talking to a couple other content creators, a couple writers, I mean, you know, you saw what happened behind the scenes. The snowball effect was pretty strong, and we started having people contact us to be a part of the team, and couldn't say yes to everybody, but the group, you know, we have right now, I'm very proud of, and that's going to continue to evolve, you know, through time. And that's one of the cool things about it is I never wanted to get stale, and I want the writers to keep doing original ideas, and we're always going to keep looking for good talent to bring on board.
Yeah, and a lot of the content is going to come from the changes we see coming in the hobby, different things coming to the forefront. Obviously Fanatics begins their, you know, 75% domination of the hobby and stuff they want to do, right? We can give our thoughts and takes on it, good and bad. And that's a nice thing. It's not, doesn't have to be all negative. It can be a positive article with some things you don't like. It can be, you know, an article where you focus on some things you're not a fan of, but also say what you want to see. So if you can kind of, you know, cover both sides of that coin, and you really, you know, while sometimes it's not always easy thinking about what direction you want to go or what topic you want to cover, I think this hobby, it's so fluid and it's changing so much that it's not as difficult to write. And let's say if it would have been maybe 30 years ago where there wasn't a lot of fluidity or changes and it was kind of set in its ways. I think the way the hobby is makes content, not even just written, but even podcast versions a lot easier to do. So that's going to be the fun part. When you mentioned it to me, you know, I think this is a question a lot of people say, well, there's a couple other sites that are doing this sort of already, but and it's what I said to you, right? And you were already thinking it, right? You're going to be different than that. While there may be some similarities, we don't need another, a carbon copy. And there's a lot more, let's be honest, there's a lot more writers involved with Hobby News Daily than maybe some of those other sites, where I think you're covering more ground and more niche areas that maybe they might not cover as well. And then you got the content creation side of it too, that might be missing. So it's not what's being done already. It's a different spin on things. And I think that's important to note. And I think it's something you get asked a lot, like what are you going to do different that's not being done already? I'll let I kind of gave my assessment there, but I'll let you speak to that as well.
Thank you for the question, because I know people are thinking it anyway. And this is a question I've gotten, you've gotten in other forms, a million times. We are not trying to be in a lane that already exists. There are great people doing great sites, and they have for a long time. And I'm fans of those sites, and I read those sites, and I have not one bad word to say about any of the sites that exist in the hobby that are covering news content. My goal was to create a different lane, a lane that says, yes, we can have written word, but let's take this a lot further. We don't just want to report on X, Y, and Z. We also want to have feature articles on a range of topics. At the same time, you do have to cover topical issues. If you remember back at the Mint with the BGS back and forth, we had people doing the Morning Minute, within a day, and covered that for 2 or 3 days on the Morning Minute, just giving different people's perspectives. And in fact, I think we got yours on that one. And that's what we're able to do. We're able to react to some stuff, but at the same time, give this area for long form or other types of topics. And that's, I don't want to say that's the secret sauce, but that's the differentiator, is that, we can have a link to a video podcast. I think our website is fresh. It's a whole different look. Nobody who goes to our website, I think, confuses us for being in the same lane as other companies right now. Now, sure, can that change? Absolutely. But, the substance behind the website is just as important. We run approximately, 14 to 17 writers on staff at any time putting in original articles. That's a lot of original content coming out every month. Are we going to be maybe the first ones to report on an auction closing? Maybe, maybe not. But are we going to be the first ones to talk about a deep dive into, 64 Philadelphia football? We might be. And that's one of the cool things. So I tell people, it's both your sports section front page, which kind of already exists, but it's also the best of your personal interest. Like somebody snuck it in the newspaper for you, just for you. And combining, the personal and the general for the hobby, I think is really where we find a nice lane.
Yeah. And I failed to mention something that you mentioned too, when we're talking about the differences between what already was existing in Hobby News Daily, right? Is, Monday through Friday, and sometimes on the weekend, if there's breaking news, every morning there's going to be a, 3 to 6 minute podcast, the Hobby News Daily Minute. And, none of the ones we're talking about are doing that. And at least, it'd be interesting to see if suddenly
maybe by the time maybe when this airs, there'll be 3 new podcasts every morning, that you can find.
If that happens too, it's imitation is the sincerest form of flattery. But that's what you're getting now. You know what I mean? That's what you're given now every morning of someone. And it's quick. It can be consumed very easily in comparison to a 45-minute or an hour show. But it covers a lot of bases, including some sports. Who did good? It might even be as simple as, like, what a big game last night. Who set a milestone or a record breaker? Because as we both know, and everyone else probably listening to this podcast right now, right, what happens on the athletic surfaces and fields directly impact the hobby, right, and values and collectability and that sort of thing. So they're married to each other. So you have to cover that aspect. And I don't, you know, not a lot of other sites kind of meld those two worlds all the time. And I think the site, the daily podcast will do a great job, or is doing a great job of that, and will continue to.
Thank you. I the biggest compliment I got is somebody told me that between their morning routine of their shower, a quick bite to eat, and the ride to work, they can usually get the Morning Minute and a new article in easily and start their day with a little bit of a hobby smile. So I would say that's the best compliment I can get from anybody, is that we can start the day with a hobby smile. And I know it's corny, but anybody who knows me knows that I bleed corny. So I have no apologies for that. I love the hobby, and I just want to help it grow. And I'll give a shout out to anybody out there. I continue to scream from the rafters. If you're somebody who's qualified to write or contribute and have good ideas and new visions, we are never done bringing in good people. So I'll just give a shout out to anybody who feels that, you know, if they're hearing this for the first time or didn't know we existed, check us out at hobbynewsdaily.com. And if you think you have something to contribute, you know, feel free to DM me or email me.
Yeah, no doubt.
Someone's at my door. I've got to get that. Be right back.
For nearly 50 years, Sports Collectors Digest has been the voice of the hobby, bringing you comprehensive coverage of the sports collectible industry. From industry news, auction results, market analysis, and in-depth stories about collectors and their collections, Sports Collectors Digest has everything you need to know about the hobby. SCD is also your leading source for listings of sports collectible dealers, card shops, card shows, and the latest from the industry's top companies. To check out all the latest news or to subscribe to the hobby's oldest magazine, visit sportscollectorsdigest.com or call 1-800-829-5561. For more than 30 years, Robert Edward Auctions has been the nation's premier auction house, specializing in sports memorabilia and trading cards. With significant experience and expertise in all major sport, non-sport, and Americana collectibles, REA has helped clients achieve record-breaking prices for their items and has done so with a reputation for integrity and transparency. By actively partnering with collectors and enthusiasts throughout the entire process, REA has created the hobby's most trusted forum for selling high-quality collectibles. Go to RobertEdwardAuctions.com for more information on how to buy or sell in their next auction.
Thanks for sticking with us. Let's return to the show.
You got to remember this, as you well know, right? This site is in its early, you know, it's first or second inning here. So you're going to have even more than what people we've talked about. There's going to be additional people coming on board. I got to give some props to your wife, Laura. She does a lot of the behind the scenes stuff with the site. She's incredibly talented. You know, I have a website for this show, and it's pretty much plug and play and less detailed than the Hobby News Daily site. And it's not always easy. And so she has her work cut out for, and yet she does a great job. Just kind of talk about, you know, her role and how important it is.
What role does my wife play and how important is she, John? She is the most important part of Hobby News Daily. She quite literally some nights, and you know this, especially when we were first starting, I mean, making revisions and edits to stuff after midnight, you know, all hours, on her lunch break from her real job, and you know, all night when she'd get home. She just did an unbelievable job. She's extremely talented. Laura, I love you. You're the best. Her only two flaws are her taste in men and her willingness to go along with their shenanigans. So other than her completely supporting everything I do, which is clearly a mistake, she's fantastic. Thank you for the shout out to her. It's more than deserving, and I know she'll kill me for giving her this much attention, but she deserves.
Yeah, no, and I like you said, I've seen it firsthand, and I thought it was important to acknowledge that. Plus it now she has to listen to the episode too, so it's an extra download. I'm kidding.
He's not Laura. When you're listening, he's serious.
Don't listen to it at the same time. Download it another time. But all joking aside, like there's so much different again with what you're doing than what's really previously been done. One thing I want to even mention or focus on or highlight is Ryan from Gemrate has really gotten on board with Hobby News Daily, and he's providing some exclusive Gemrate data every month that you won't get anywhere else. You have to come to Hobby News Daily to get it. This month he's featuring Hall of Fame data from Hall of Famers, and there's going to be obviously different incarnations of different things in coming months. Talk about that deal and Ryan making that available to the site.
Well, you can first of all, shout out to my neighbors for getting their lawn cut right now. I appreciate that. Anytime you want, guys. Ryan, I had a meeting with at first, and I think he looked at me like I had three heads when I told him what I wanted to do and what I was hoping his involvement would be. And he couldn't have been nicer. He's like, sounds great. I'm on board. Kind of patted me on the head. Just let me know when this thing's up and running. And then I got back in touch with him and I said, I want to show you the update. And, I'm proud to say he was kind of blown away and has just been 100% supporter from the beginning. He has, similar to the writers, this gives him a venue to use some of the data he's gathered and some of the things he likes and to put it out there in a different way, in a different form. So one of the coolest things I learned, we had the initial monthly grading data, but then he did the report on Hall of Fame rookie grading. And, as somebody who's in the hobby, who's somebody who's a collector, who's somebody who works with clients, I'd like to think that I'm pretty smart on what goes on. But if you ask me which Hall of Famer had the most rookie cards graded in the last 2 years, I might not have said Ted Simmons, but Ted Simmons is the answer. And I learned that from Ryan's data on this report he did. Now, logically, it makes sense. Ted Simmons was never thought to be a Hall of Famer. He gets inducted into the Hall of Fame. Now there's a rush to grade his cards. So there's a logic behind it. But the fascinating part to me is just even having that information developed and out there. If I'm a Hall of Fame rookie chaser, maybe there's a Ted Simmons bubble. I want to wait a year. Or maybe I just, have that Ted Simmons card I never thought about grading. And it's like, heck yeah, he's a Hall of Famer. I forgot about that. But either way, the data is fascinating and going back and seeing that. So Ryan and I share a love of analytics, a love of data, and he's just been unbelievably supportive. So shout out to Gemrate, shout out to Ryan. I think, as he keeps surprising me, I don't always know how much he's going to deliver, and he delivers a ton of fascinating stuff. So we're thrilled to have a partnership with him. We do get some exclusive data before it's released other places. We get some projects just for ourselves. So this is once again, somebody else who loves the hobby, and we've created a great partnership to get that out there. And I think people enjoy it when they come to hobbynewsdaily.com.
And again, this is stuff that's only for Hobby News Daily. You're not going to find it anywhere else. You're not even going to find it on Gemrate's site. This is what he's providing. That's how much he believes in what you're doing to do something like that. And that's very, very cool and different. Good, I love looking at that too. And I'm not always an analytics guy when it comes to hobby stuff, but that sort of analytics on that level, broken up to that point, how can you not find it interesting to see what the trends are, what people are thinking, and sort of get a look behind what's going on? I think that's just a very cool look into sort of, you know, where the hobby is and kind of that temperature, right? So I'll ask you, you know, you're a few weeks in, you knew there would be some difficulties, obviously. What has been maybe the pleasantest surprise and maybe the most difficult thing, you know, both worlds, both sides of that coin?
Great question. Have I taken a step back yet to the most pleasant part so far has been the feedback, without a doubt. I as much as I'm in love with this stuff, if I'm the only one going to the site, then it's not doing anybody any good. So the feedback, not just in the numbers we're seeing, but the actual direct contact people are giving to me, like, hey, you know, saw that when it launched, you know, very cool to add this to the hobby. Just hearing that, and a lot of people are using the term adding to the hobby, and I love that. Is we're not replacing anything, we're not trying to redo anything. We're addition to the hobby, and I love that compliment. So that's got to be the most rewarding, fulfilling, and reading some of the articles from the writers, and obviously getting turned on to some of the YouTubers and podcasters that I wasn't as familiar with. What's been the most challenging? I think anytime you put a product in front of the general public, you're going to find challenges you never knew that you had. I think I referenced it earlier. Our first newsletter went out 3 times. You know, okay, well, you know, we learned the second one only went out 1 time, and we plan on only emailing a newsletter.
I got that email, and I thought it was 3 different ones promoting, and every time I opened it up, it was the same email, and it was like Groundhog Day. I was like,
it's the Oprah Winfrey strategy. You get an email, you get an email, you get an email, everybody gets an email. But that was a learning. Listen, we learned on that. There was an email that went out that the links weren't working, and you know, we had to adjust and fix that. There's been some challenges with so many writers, and I know this sounds silly, on just basic formatting issues and getting stuff on the website to have a consistent, clean look. You know how important that is, you know, that we have that uniform look on the site. And we try our darndest and try to work with the writers so they don't have to do too much work other than the writing. And then other than that, I think it's just answering a lot of why should I check it out questions, which is a very fair question. But I tell people, give it 5 minutes and tell me if you still need to ask again. You know, I think once you go there, it's self-explanatory on what you can get out of the site. Now, does that mean it has to be for everybody? Of course not. Does that mean you have to like every article? Of course not. But does it mean there's something on there you'll probably enjoy? I think so.
Yeah, no doubt. And again, not just because I'm involved with it. This is from just a plain hobbyist perspective. The site is different than what you sort of expect. It's sort of a more modernized, fresher look, if you ask me. And just the way you set it up with obviously Laura, you know, being a big part of that. It's just, you know, what I kind of thought the site would look like when I knew you were going to do it, and what it really does look like. It's even more impressive than I imagined. And you know, don't take my word for it. You know, shame. Plug for you, but it's I really feel this way. Is, you know, everyone listening, go to hobbynewsdaily.com and see what we're talking about. Don't just take it for, you know, our word for it. See for yourself and give your own take and assessment on it. Coming down the home stretch here, Danny, you know, again, you're in the early innings here, a few weeks in. I mean, we don't want to give out, you know, you don't want to give away everything, but kind of where do you want to see the site go? Maybe some future things people can look forward to. I know you mentioned there'll probably be more writers added to the arsenal. In addition to that, what can people look forward to?
Great question. Definitely more diversity in writing on the content side. I think the way our hobby is expanding at such a rapid pace, there's more sports, more companies, more cards, more topics, just more things to cover. And I'd love to continue the push into covering the hobby, even from a memorabilia standpoint. I think that's one area that initially I didn't think of it as its own being, but should probably, you know, focus more on covering sports memorabilia collecting as its own thing. So I'd love to get somebody who can write, you know, full time with that. other than that, I mean, looking forward, I mean, it's technological advances. That's the biggest challenge, I think, for any company. And being web-based, that's the ultimate goal, is to move forward. We are trying to get to a place or get to a sponsor that can move us to a full mobile platform. We have had talks to try to get a full mobile app up and running, and that's the goal. When that'll happen, I'm not sure, but that would be the kind of the top of the mountain for me, just for ease for the consumer. And that's what it's all about. I just want it to be an easy, useful product. People who listen to our Morning Minute now know if you go to the homepage, it's right up front. You can just click play. So we've tried to make it as easy as possible on the phone. You can even subscribe to it and not even go to the page, but eventually we want to have our own mobile site, grow all the writers, and just continue to make the content available to everybody in the hobby.
Yeah, it's going to be crazy to be a small part of it and watch where it goes and grows. And it's going to be a fun ride. There's, you know, like anything, right? There'll be a bump in the road here and there, but where it goes and the journey along the way, right, will be a memorable one. And again, it's different. You know, again, when you told me you were thinking of doing this, I'm like, you know, I love it, but you know, you've got to do something that's not being done. And I think you are. I'm biased, but I generally think that's what's going on. And so I implore everyone to check the site out for yourself. Again, we could talk about it for 30 minutes, but you know, it's nothing like seeing it rather than just hearing two guys, you know, wax poetically about it. So it's hobbynewsdaily.com. But also, you know, before we go, give out any other socials or anything else you want to direct people to as well, Danny.
Absolutely. Like you said, hobbynewsdaily.com, at hobbynewsdaily on social. Me personally, I'm Sports Balt. I am from Baltimore, so Sports, B-A-L-T. I have my own original thoughts and content, but right now I would be honored if everybody would give hobbynewsdaily.com a look, sign up for the newsletter, comes out every Monday, you know, really be a part of a great hobby.
Yeah, and I'll just add to that a little salesman in me here. Like, if you do find you like the content and the site, you know, spread that word, right? Tell people about, you know, the hobby community is a great resource. Share that knowledge, share things you enjoy with your fellow hobbyists as well. That will help, obviously, grow the site and grow what you're doing and everyone else is doing as well. So, well, thanks, Danny, for joining me to talk about this. I know we don't get to chat often. I don't know when the next time we'll get to talk, but thanks for coming on.
I think this is the best behavior we've ever been. Thanks for having me.
All right, take care.
See you, buddy.
Now, 100% transparency. Most people know that me and Danny are very close friends, and that's a great thing, right? The friendships we make in the hobby, and you never know where it could take you, right? And what can come of it. And but that being said, you know, with this Hobby News Daily website, it doesn't matter whether I'm friends with Danny or not. I believe in the website. It's got great people involved in it besides Danny. You know, you got about 18 different people contributing to the site. You got outside, you know, even other content creators contributing. You got Ryan and Gemrate contributing. So this is a major conglomerate effort. It's not just me or Danny alone. This is a lot of people. His wife, Laura, as you heard, very involved as well. So this is a super group effort. It's a great site. I can't implore you enough to check it out, hobbynewsdaily.com. And just like the name says, every day there's going to be something new, a new podcast, a new show, a new article, some new data potentially from Gemrate, and trying to do something different and fresh, really happy to be a small part of it. Check it out.
Iron Sports Cards is your number one source for all your PSA and other grading submissions. Their elite status improves turnaround times, Heck, they even provide the card savers. Their chat rooms provide updates on all your submissions. They also offer wax options and single cards to cover all the bases. Check them out on Facebook at Iron Sports Cards Group or on the web at ironsportscards.com, or even give them a call at 1-877-IRON-PSA. Rob's got you covered.
Hi, this is Pat Hughes, Cubs announcer, coming to you from the Sports Card Shop in beautiful New Buffalo, Michigan. The Gocher family has built an incredible place here for collectors to buy, sell, and trade cards and memorabilia. Be sure to stop by and let them show you around. TheSportsCardShop.com, connecting sports, athletes, the hobby, and collectors around the world.
That's a wrap on another edition of the Sports Card Nation podcast. Thank you to all the awesome listeners out there. Without you, there is no us. Thank you to all our great guests who drive this show, and also our wonderful sponsors who help us produce the great hobby content every week. Remember, another Hobby Quick Hits episode drops every Monday, and Sports Card Nation returns again next Friday. If you like the shows, we appreciate those positive reviews. Be well, and always remember, the hobby is the people.